Go with me to Psalms 27. Psalms 27. I'm going to let you in my stash on today. Psalms 27, verse 4. And I'm going to do quite a bit of reading. I'm going to sum it up. Amen? Amen. Are you praying for me?
Yes, God.
Amen. My voice is almost gone already. Y'all ready? Psalms 27 and 4, one of my favorite passages of scripture. It says, one thing have I desired of the Lord. Somebody say one thing.
One thing.
Somebody say one thing.
One thing.
One thing have I, come on in, desired of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
That will I seek. That I may dwell, somebody say dwell.
Dwell.
In the house of the Lord. All the days of my life. To behold the beauty of the Lord. And to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me high upon a rock, and now my head shall be lifted up above my enemies all around me. Therefore I will offer sacrifice of joy in his tabernacle. I will sing, yes, I will sing praises to the Lord. Oh, God, help me here. Hear, oh Lord, when I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me and answer me. Anybody need answers? When you said, seek my face, my heart, somebody said my heart. Said to you, your face, Lord, will I seek. Do not hide your face from me. Do not turn your servant away in anger. You have been my help. Oh God, y'all don't know where to shout. You have been my help. Do not leave me, here it is again, nor forsake me. Oh God of my salvation, when my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take care of me. Oh God, teach me, here it is, teach me your ways, oh Lord, and lead me in the smooth path. Anybody need a smooth path? Lead me in a smooth path, because my enemies, here it is, do not deliver me to the will of my adversary. Do not deliver me. Y'all listen how this man is praying. Do not deliver me to the will of my adversary. For false witnesses have risen against me, and such as breathe out violence. Here it is. I would have fainted.
Yes.
Oh God, I would have lost heart, he says. And King James said, I would have fainted unless I believe. Somebody say, I believe.
I believe.
That I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Here it is. Wait on the Lord. Here it is. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage. And he shall strengthen your heart.
Yes.
Wait, I say.
Wait on the Lord.
I got chills when I said it at that time. Wait, I say. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Briefly for a moment, just ask your neighbor, do you have the attitude of a worshiper? I come over here like this on today. Look at your other neighbor and say, do you have the attitude of a worshiper?
Yes.
You may be seated in the presence of the living God. Do you have
yes.
an attitude of a worshiper? Do you have, somebody shout, attitude. Do you have the attitude of a worshiper? Wednesday, I talked to those of you that was here on Wednesday. You would take the one out of the middle of the pack. Praise God. Big old chair with the end, you take the one at the middle. That's all right. Thank you, Steve. Thank you. Okay, y'all ready? Y'all ready for Bible study? Okay. Y'all look like y'all want to study the Bible today. Amen. Y'all looking at me crazy again. I come against the spirit of looking at me. Praise God. The reason why I said that, because I told him Wednesday night, Psalm 63, as I reflect back, he said, oh God, you are my God. You have to know that God is your God. You have to know God is your God. You have to know God is your God when things are going good. And you have to know God is your God when things are going bad. You have to know God is your God when you get sick. You have to know God is your God when things are going good and you are healed. You have to know God is your God. Look at somebody say, God is your God. You have heard the testimony of Big Mama, Grandmama, Big Daddy, Look Daddy, whatever y'all call them, you don't heard the testimony. You heard the testimony of your mother. You heard the testimony of your father. What is your report? What is your testimony of your God? Mm-hmm. So on Wednesday, he said, early in the morning will I seek you. Early in the morning will I seek you. You must understand that you have to have a devotion in your life. You have to get up in the morning with the mindset that I am going to praise my God. Amen. In Psalm 63, it was very unusual because David had a lot of success in his life. And he, at this point, he had come out of the pasture hanging with the sheep. Now he done been in the palace, but now something happened in his own home. And now the question is, can you praise God when things are going bad in your prayer? Oh God. Anybody can praise God when things are going good, but can you praise God when something hits you close in the vicinity of your home? Can you lift your hands and give God praise when things are going bad? In Psalm 63, David had always got the victory over his enemies. He always got the victory over his enemies, but this time here, it came close to home. He couldn't muster up the same energy he had when he came against the Goliath. This time, this is a bigger giant. It's not a bigger giant in statue, but it's a bigger giant in the spirit, because he cannot fight him, because this is my child. Oh, God. Ain't nothing like being broken hearted by your own children. Y'all ain't standing to me up in here. This time, his son came up against him. His son ran him out of the palace. Absalom was his son. He was a good-looking man. I begin to read the story about Absalom again. Absalom had stood at the gate, and he won the heart of the people because he acted like, somebody say, he acted like. He acted like he had a heart for the people. He acted like he wanted to help the people. He acted like he was going to be there for the people, but yet still, it was all just a front because he wanted his daddy's position. I come to tell you today, don't you move out of position, because God will protect you. Y'all ain't saying that again. So I came and I said, church, I left last Sunday and I was heavy. I was heavy last Sunday when I left because the sermon went good but didn't end good, because I felt the heaviness that was in the room. That was such a heaviness. See, as your spiritual leader, sometimes God will allow me to go through some things and feel some things. things so I can teach you some things. Y'all hear me? Sometimes I got to go through it before you go through it. Sometimes, in order for you to remember, I said this month will be a month of deliverance. But God spoke to me in my prayer time and said it's not just a month of deliverance, but it is a month of delivery. Oh, y'all didn't say that. Some of you are praying in the spirit, but you don't even know that you're about to give birth. Oh, every woman in here that had a baby should have said something. Oh, God. You know how it was. You know you hadn't seen that baby yet, but yet still, you went through some pains and you felt some kicking you in your stomach. You wanted to quit, but something about making you want to see what the end will be. Oh, God. That's the way I feel right now. I'm just trying to wait to see what the end will be. Somebody is in the first trimester. Somebody is in the second trimester. Somebody is in the third trimester. And it's almost time. God, I wish I could preach this like a minute. It's almost time for you to get in the hospital and God mercy, he will tell you to push. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing. I don't care if the baby coming sideways.
He said he was in a dry and thirsty place. And he said, he lifted up
in the wilderness of his life. In Psalm 63, you gotta go read it. He kept up his hands anyway. He said, he didn't even have to worry about his enemies. He said, you're gonna lead my enemies to the jackals. You're gonna lead my enemies to the wild animals to eat up. I ain't gotta fight for me. That's why I'm learning to get my hands over my situation. Look at somebody and say, get your hands over your situation, and you got to be a your prayer life. Because David said, he said, so I look for you in the sanctuary. Here it is. He said, I look for you in Psalm 63 and 2. He said, I look for you in the sanctuary. Here it is. I didn't just come to see was my cousin here. He said, I look for you in the sanctuary to see your power. And then he said, and your glory. Oh God. I didn't come here. And he had to remind me that because sometimes when things are not going your way, oh God, you got to force yourself to think about God's word. He said, I meditate on his word. Okay, now let's get to the day. Because on Wednesday we learned following hard after God. We learned that we got to pursue. Somebody say pursue. After God. But on today, I want you to look at because we're talking about today the attitude of worship. The attitude of worship. Look at somebody say, it's time for a change. The reason why I keep telling you to look at somebody and say something, because the only time, see, you've been letting the devil beat you up for a long time, and now it's time for you to say something, because the devil, you ain't supposed to be looking at the devil eye to eye. Guess what? You're supposed to be looking down at the devil, because the Bible says the devil is under your feet. Y'all ain't saying that up in here. The devil is up under your feet, and you got to know the power that you're working with. Okay? So now, we're talking about today the attitude of worship. The attitude of worship. And attitude, here it is, attitude really does matter. Attitude really does matter. It could make a difference between a good day and a bad day. Your attitude. Oh, God. Oh, I got to remind myself that all the time. And I'm going to get on my nerves when I go to work. Praise God. I hope they ain't looking at it on YouTube. Sometimes, you know, you're not the only people that you're talking in, but sometimes kid folk can get on your nerves. Yeah. Oh, I ain't gonna look at none of my kid folk today. Yeah. Oh, God. Sometimes attitude is the difference between a good marriage and a bad marriage. That one right there, I heard it get past that one real fast. So I heard it, I said, move on, preacher, move on. I heard that in the spirit. Gratitude toward God. Amen. We come to show our gratitude toward God. it's good that we come together. He tells to not to forsake the assembling of ourselves. But I want you to understand, the opposite of gratitude is entitlement. Some of us think that we are entitled to be blessed. You really, I don't deserve anything that I have. I'm just blessed, really, to be alive. Amen. And everything I have added to that, y'all ain't gonna say nothing, is truly a blessing because really I have my righteousness, the Bible says, is as filthy rags. Oh God. So David said, I thirst after God. I thirst. I want to talk to you real quick. Number one, why we worship God. We worship God, how we worship God. We worship God willingly. David said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continuously be in my mouth. We worship God willingly. We worship God continually. We worship God personally. And we worship God corporately. Four areas. We worship God willingly. And we worship God continually. And we worship God personally, okay? We worship God corporately. When we say corporately, that's when David said, oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together, okay? So there's three areas I want to talk to you on today about these four areas of worship. And I'm going to put it in a nutshell, okay? I want you to understand. Somebody say attitude.
Attitude.
The first attitude of worship I want you to understand is that there is a desire. You have to have a desire to worship.
Right.
Come on. You have to have a desire to worship. Okay? You have to have a desire to worship. Okay. Right. How many of y'all love, how many of y'all like soda pop? How many of y'all like soda?
Amen.
Y'all like soda? How many of y'all like Dr. Pepper? Okay. Y'all like Dr. Pepper? Who like Pepsi? Okay. Do your children know what kind of soda you like?
Absolutely.
All right. See, worship is like this. Our children are watching how we worship. And they stay, and you are giving them the way you worship is giving them a desire to worship God to the magnitude of how you worship God. If you sit in church like this, they gonna sit in church like this. Yeah. If you at the church, go to Applebee's and you sit at the table and you talk about everybody in the church and you say, Lord, they're full of complaints. Oh God, guess what? Your child gonna do the same thing. They're gonna do the same thing. So what? How what we desire is what we are giving out to our children. So I need two children over here, real quick.
Over here. Come with your seat. Over here. All right. Hurry up. Y'all remember when you used to go to the store and they used to have a taste test?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, who kids we got up here? Uh-oh. I want to see how much your kid know about you.
Good job, man.
All right. Y'all ready? See, God is not getting ready like me. He's already ready.
Come on, Pastor.
Y'all been saying it
right.
I had to get ready, but everything God has for you is already ready.
Yeah.
Now hear me? So your attitude toward worship, it depends on how fast you will get what you have already ordered.
Yeah.
What he already ordered. See, sometimes, you know, he got to change your appetite. Because your attitude is that you're supposed to get filet mignon all the time. So he got to break you down to a chicken fried steak. Y'all understand that up again. So here it is. What you think your mother like, Pepsi or Dr. Pepper? Just pick one real fast.
You should like
eat
it.
I can't use him. Okay, pick one. Real fast. Just pick Pepsi or Dr. Pepper. Okay, Pepsi. Now, I want you to taste one of these, both of those, and tell me which one is Dr. Pepper. All right, he got it right. Praise God. You say those names, put that on church. The Bible says, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Amen. So therefore, he already knows. And now, the reason why he was able to acknowledge which one it was, because it had already been introduced to him. Y'all say, y'all ain't gonna want to look at me today. Because you, I'm the leader.
Yes, Lord.
I don't have to tell them I'm the leader. I don't have to get in an argument with my wife and say, you know, I'm the head of this house.
Amen.
When you're doing it, you just do it.
Yeah.
You ain't gotta talk about it. Quit talking about it and be about it. If you're a worshiper, we ought to see some signs that you are a worshiper. Go ahead and take a sip. She like praying like, oh God, please let me get my mama's ring. She just worshiped a few minutes ago. Huh? Tell the Lord thank you. She praying about it, y'all. I think she's gonna mix it up on me. Hurry up, I gotta get it. Which one is it? Just take a guess. Sometimes it takes us a little longer than others.
Yes.
I'm working in a mess some kind of way, you first tell you. Man? Okay, I ain't got that big of a skin. You know why I'm talking to her? Because sometimes when we don't know what decision to make, if you got a real prayer life, he will whisper in your ear, give you directions on which one to choose from. I just gave her the answer, but the thing is, can you hear the whisper when I give you the answer?
Oh, yeah.
Okay?
Oh, yeah.
Okay? Okay? Which one is Pepsi? Just pointing to which one is Pepsi. This is Pepsi. This Dr. Pepper. Which one is Pepsi? Amen. Which one is Dr. Pepper? So when I switch things around, which one is Pepsi? Which one is Dr. Pepper? You need to taste again? Oh, I'm gonna work it in the message. Yeah. I want you to be mindful that we're going into 2016, and some of the things you've been through, you can't go through it again. So the devil, what he would do, he would switch things around, but it is the same, here it is, it's the same tactic, but coming in a different method. It's still Dr. Pepper on this side, Pepsi on this side, both of them on the same drink. Switch it around, all right? Come on, thank you, baby. So look here. his fears. How many of you know that you got some fears? Uh-huh. And some of the reasons why we have made bad decisions is because we have fears. Remember, I told you fear is false evidence of being real.
Yes.
False evidence of being real. So the enemy wants you to think that what God promised you is not real. So you bring up false evidence to come up against you so you can not know that you won't make a choice. Come on. You won't have a desire. And so now you must understand, look what he said. He says in verse 27 and 4, he said, one thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after. Here it is. David's greatest desire, y'all hold on a minute. David's greatest desire was to live in God's presence. David's greatest desire was to live in God's presence. And he said, that I will seek after you. I want to know, are you worshiping God? Is your one thing that you reason why you lift in your hands is because your desire is just to get another house, or your desire is to get another car? God said, that's why he got to break some of them bad habits that we have so you can have the testimony of the one thing. David said, one thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after. What are you seeking after today? What are you seeking after today? That I will seek after. Then the next thing, he said, that I will seek after. He said, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord. Here it is, all the days of my life to behold the beauty of the Lord. When we worship God, yeah, when we worship God, it's beautiful. When we worship God together, it is a sweet aroma in the air. When we worship God, that is the time when you forget about all of your problems. When we worship God, that's when you come in connection with him. And you say, tell him I'm in love with you. Not because you have blessed me to pay all my bills this month, but I am worshiping you. I'm seeking after you. See, if you are seeking after God, that means, Lord, I'm going to look for you no matter where I am. I don't have to be in the palace. I can be in the pit. But I'm going to keep seeking after God. Oh, God, I wish y'all would hear me today. I just wonder, how are you seeking after God? See, some of us don't read our Bible until we get to church. And so now, the only time you see God is when you are in the sanctuary. But they have to develop a sanctuary no matter where he was. So you got to understand, whenever you praise God, you are praising him in his sanctuary. So when we come together in corporate praise, oh God, it's wonderful. How do you think it's going to be when we get to heaven? It's going to be worship. You will see his glory. You will seek after God. And here it is. Here it is when you seek after God. Somebody say desire.
Desire.
Now here it is. You have to have the discipline to worship God. Verse 4, verse 5 says, for in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. Hallelujah. You know what a pavilion is, don't you? Some of you go to the park and you have your baby's birthday party where? Under the pavilion. Uh-huh. And so if you know everybody can't be up under the pavilion, some of us got to make an appointment to get out of the pavilion. See, some of us, we are asking God for things. We are asking him, and you want a withdrawal, but you haven't made no deposit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
God Almighty, when you make a deposit in worship, and when you pray to the Lord, you are making a deposit. You remember, one time I went to Fiesta. I didn't hear you. One time I went to Fiesta. Y'all heard this story before. And I swiped that card. Hey, you got what I need? You start praying.
Oh, yeah.
You know you ain't got no money in the first place.
Yeah.
Huh? I swiped that card. I was praying in the name of Jesus. Yeah, amen. And then it just said, in suffering from us. I was suffering. I was insufficient. It was suffering, praise God. So I said, oh God. I put in my pocket. Hey, oh, okay. Look, I gave you wrong card. So you got a lie. Come on, you don't want no money on that card. So here, try another one. Hallelujah. His grace. I thought prayer for grace. Man, that one said, in suffering from us too. Manage what little bit I have.
Yeah.
He said, if you be faithful over a few things, here it is, I'll make you rule over many. So now you have to have a discipline. When you have an account that says insufficient funds, then you got to know that you got to still have a praise. You still got to have a worship. You still got to lift your hands and give God some praise. You got to be able to give God praise. That is discipline. It's discipline because, God, I'm worshiping you, not because of what you give me, but because of who you are. So it got to be a discipline in your life. See, the enemy will try. Here it is. The enemy will try to use condemnation against you. You know you've done something wrong, and then he will try to get you to come in here, and the first thing you do is think about all of the stuff you've done wrong. The devil's job is to bring back to your remembrance all the things you have done wrong, and now you can't lift your hands because you have condemnation in your ear. You've got to be able to shut that thing off and give God some real, pure, true worship. You understand what I'm saying? You've got to shut that thing off. That's why the scripture said, create in me a clean heart and renew, here it is, renew the right spirit within me. So you've got to create, you have God know what you've been through. Be honest with God. Repent and turn away from it. But don't you stop worshiping. You got to understand, no matter what you have done, God will forgive you if you have a heart of true repentance.
Yeah. Oh, God. Oh, I heard a preacher say this morning. I need y'all to listen to me real good. Listen real good. I heard a preacher say this morning that there were some saints that went to testify at the liquor store. In front of the liquor store. They went to testify in front of the, they supposed to be winning souls, right? But this man came out. He came out of the liquor store already drunk. And the saints start calling him, oh, we bind that devil in the name of Jesus. We repent him in the name of Jesus. Just came out of the liquor store. And the man looked at him and said, with tears in his eyes, and he said, do you think I really want to be like this? See, some of us are snared by the enemy. We don't know how to get out.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Yeah. Saints, we got to have the attitude of worship that we've been pouring them out. Then somebody don't know how to get out. But every time when the pressure's on them, they turn to the weakness. But they got to learn what God said. When you read, oh, God, that's what I'm strong. So I got to remember, no matter what my weakness is, wherever I'm weak, that's where he's strong. So I need you to teach me how to give it over to God.
Angels, you would never protect you every time. Oh, I'm looking at me like that. God lifted up my head. Oh, y'all ain't saying to me. Oh, y'all so weak out there on my nerves. Oh, God, sometimes when I come in here, I didn't want to preach. Sometimes when I came in here, before I started preaching, I didn't want to come in because you look down upon me. But part of the reason why I was able to overcome is because I seen something that had an attitude of worship. I said, Lord, something must be real about that day. And then one Wednesday night in a Lutheran Bible, I got the Holy Ghost one day. Now he's saying to me, as soon as I left that place, we had a car accident. The enemy tried to discourage you. As soon as you say, I'm going to change. But you have to know that I made it in my mind. I'm going to change. I'm going to change. I'm going to change. I don't know who am I talking to. But this time, you've got to change. Your attitude has to change. Your attitude will carry your attitude. Somebody shout, change. Change. If I worship, I need a new nation of worship.
Children have an appetite to worship.
They sing with you've been through. They know the secrets at the house. One day they won't be able to hold on. Because God said the secret things belong to the Lord.
Yeah.
He said, but I will reveal it to you in Deuteronomy 29. In 29, he said, I will reveal it to you and your children. You and your children, you have a responsibility to make sure your children have an appetite, an attitude for worship.
That's right. Amen.
For worship. Worship. I know y'all are tired of me talking about this, but I'm saying it until you get it. When my dad passed away, reason why I'm still standing today is because he didn't lose his worship.
That's right.
He didn't lose his worship.
Right. Yeah.
He might have forgot his name, but he said, lift your hands and tell the Lord, thank you.
Yeah.
Oh God, I just need you to feel the real aroma of God. Whatever. Oh God, I gotta quit. There is real worship. Stop complaining about what's not right and worship. And God will change whatever ain't right if you continue to worship. Saints, this is not worship. When I tell you, when I want my children to do something, if you tell a man, women, if you tell a man, I gotta quit. Okay, I'm quit for the last word. If you tell a man, you keep beating a man up. You keep beating him up. Tell him what he ain't. Tell him what he And men, if you keep beating up your woman, and every time you ain't got nothing positive to say. When you tell a man, oh, baby, you brought some groceries in the house. Oh, you so strong. Well, I come up in there with 49 bags. Y'all ain't saying no, baby. I come up in there just so she can tell me I'm strong with it. Huh? Don't you tell me I'm strong. Y'all ain't saying no, baby. When you put on another arm, when you see, when you communicate with me. Oh, y'all ain't saying no, baby. Last thing. Oh, God. Before I lost some of this weight, Sister Brandon, you should be glad. I didn't have an insecurity because she made me feel good. She let me know that I'm her man. Y'all ain't saying it up in here. Y'all ain't saying it up in here. So no matter how big I had a 36, y'all. Them little handle with their children, boy, with them, but because there was compliments.
That's right.
Listen, you have to learn how to encourage one another.
Right.
Attitude of worship. Our lives will be better if our attitude change.
Yeah.
Our worship will be better if our attitude change. Our children will be better if our attitude
changes. Yeah.
So now, God, I'm going to wait on you. Whatever you bring, Lord, help me fulfill my taste.
Yes.
Help me fulfill my appetite.
Yes, Lord.
David said, I would have fainted. Unless I believe to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. He said, teach me your ways.
Yes, yes.
You have to ask God to teach you his ways.
Yes.
Because our thoughts are not God's thoughts.
That's right.
Neither our ways are God's ways. So he has to teach us how to have a hunger and a thirst after him. Some of us like Dr. Pepper, some of us like Pepsi, whatever your appetite is, You like it because you had a thirst for it. You have to have a thirst for God like that. David says, a deer panted after the water brook, so panted I after thee, O Lord. It has to be a change. It's time for a change. It's time for a change. Don't let nobody have to push you to worship. Here he is, he would say, we've been in church too long. Y'all, I stay up to 11 o'clock watching the game. You know I had to get up at 4 o'clock. You stay up for what you want to stay up for.
Amen.
When we got real good food at the restaurant, sometimes I got to tell you, we got a lie out there, can y'all? You stay longer for what you want to stay longer for. And the reason why our attention span is short, because all of us don't have an attitude of worship. But I want to encourage you today. It's time for a change. I can't go through in 2017 what I went through in 2016. I had a tough time in 2016. But I believe God in 2017. It's going to be greater.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
If you believe it's going to be greater for you in 2017,
yes,
it's going to be greater.
Yes.
But all God needs you to do is believe and have an attitude of worship. Don't be afraid to open up your mouth and worship God. Don't be afraid to lift your hands and worship God. Don't be afraid to let tears fall from your eyes. It's pressure release when I cry. By no means I'm weak. By no means I'm weak. But God said, I'm there to collect every tear that falls from your eye. So whenever I have some victories, listen, you already have the victory. You already have the victory. But what we have to teach you is you don't have to stay stuck where you were. You don't have to stay stuck. Change your attitude. Change your attitude toward worship. When you don't have a personal relationship, a personal worship, you can't worship in the congregation. It's harder to worship in a corporate worship if you have a worship at home. If you don't worship in your car, stand on your feet, you get ready. Are you willing? Can you continue to worship? Is your worship personal? Can you worship with me in a corporate worship? Father, help us to have a desire to worship you. Teach us how to be more disciplined so we can have the duration of worship. We need the desire. We need the discipline. And we need a duration. We need a desire. We need a discipline. And we need a duration. Touch our hearts today. Father, help us to know that we already have the victory. Help us to encourage one another. We've have me.